Proverbs 20 verse 4. Proverbs 20 verse 4. The lazy person does not plow in season. Harvest comes and there is nothing to be found. So the lazy people, they don't harvest, they don't plow, they don't sow the seeds, but they are there for harvest, but they will never get anything. My dear brothers and sisters, there are many people, they don't work hard in their family, but they will be there to fight with all their siblings to get the family property, ancestral property. They won't do any contribution, but they are there to harvest. Such kinds of harvest will never give any profit. It will never grow, because you never did anything for this, never contributed anything. This is the toil and the sweat of someone else, maybe your parents or grandparents. Therefore, we have a responsibility to contribute something in every day as you grow up, and that is the only way you can benefit something out of this. The Lord wants to tell us this. Let's also read Proverbs chapter 6 verse 6 to 8. Proverbs chapter 6 verse 6 to 8. We read like this. Go to the ant. Go to the ant, you lazy bones. Consider its ways and be wise. Look at the ants and then be wise. Look at them without having any chief or any officer or ruler. It prepares its food in summer and gathers its sustenance in harvest. All the ants work together without any chief or officer or ruler, without being controlled by whips, not controlled by the powers of authority. They work hard and gather something for summer. They prepares its food in summer and gathers its sustenance in harvest. Therefore, the Lord says, look at them and learn and be wise. Let's also read the word of God. The word of God says, Ephesians chapter 4 verse 28. Thieves must give up stealing. Thieves, it's also a sign of laziness. The stealing tendency, there are many people who have this stealing tendency. That is also the basic root is sloth. Thieves must give up stealing. Rather, let them labor and work honestly with their own hands, so as to have something to share with the needy. The Lord is telling us. And Jesus says, you know, he said his attitude. Sometimes we see Jesus is walking around and then he doesn't seem to be working, but he's busy always. So we may have some feelings. We may have some justification and say, I'm like being like Jesus. But what does Jesus say about himself? John 5:17. But Jesus answered them, my Father is still working and I also am working. My Father, God himself is working and Jesus is also working. How come we don't work? How come we are not interested in working? My Father is still working and I also am working. Therefore, the Lord is inviting us to work. There are people who doesn't work for their family, doesn't do any contribution to their family. They just enjoy the hard work of someone. Husband enjoying the hard work of the wife. Wife enjoying the hard work of the husband. And parents and children enjoys the hard work of someone and not ready to contribute anything to the family. Let's read 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8. 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8. And whoever does not provide for relatives and especially for family members has denied the faith and is worse than any unbeliever. The Lord says, whoever does not provide for their relatives, when you are able to help your relatives, your father, your mother, your husband, your wife, your children, your parents, your cousins, your relations, and you, anyone who is whom you know personally, and your family members, especially your own family members, not only relatives, but your own family members, if you don't provide, you are denying the faith. has denied the faith and is worse than an unbeliever. Such people are worse than an unbeliever. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, if any one of your family members are in need, we have to help them, especially during this COVID situation. We have to contribute them. If just call them and make sure that they are all safe and they are all well provided. Otherwise, we will be answerable in front of God, especially those who are well settled. It's our duty to help those people who are struggling, those who are in the safe countries where there is security and provisions are provided, has got the responsibility to take care of their relatives in the poor countries and who are struggling to even survive even a single day. It's our duty to pray for them, and it's our duty to provide them in whatever way possible. The Lord is giving us this word of God, 1 Timothy chapter 5 verse 8. Let's examine our conscience and see, do we have this tendency? Do we have this problem? And do we have this sloth? Do we have this selfishness, not ready to help and share? Let's beg for mercy and forgiveness from the Lord.